Is anybody here with us? Could you please come forward? Could you please show yourself as a life form? As an orb? Could you come and dance? The music by the Skyliners? Could we order some beers, please? Two shots of bourbon? Have you got any Hershey bars? That's a song by the Skyliners, which was a group that existed in this particular airbase. And one of their crew, or one of their team, was a drummer who died in an air crash in Great Dunmow, which is not many miles from here. I just wondered whether he was around by any chance. Is there anybody here that used to listen to the Skyliners could come forward and just make us aware of them? I did hear a noise.
Yeah.
It wasn't something being dragged. It was just...
Yeah, like a little rumbly sound.
Yeah, just a short noise. It sounded like it was behind you.
Yeah, being pulled along a shelf or something.
Yeah. The person that made that noise, could you make it again for us, please? Is there anybody here from the 322nd? Anybody used to fly in a B-26 or a B-17?
And we have a great respect for you and what you did for our country during war as well.
Yeah.
What was that?
If it wasn't for you guys and girls who did so much for us, we wouldn't have the freedom that we have now. And your ultimate sacrifice meets with our total respect.
Can anyone else hear that tap?
Yeah.
You can.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know so many people sacrifice their lives for this country, and you'll never be forgotten.
Never.
And we'd like to thank you for giving everything you did for us.
Yep, it's behind
me,
Josie.
Yeah, I heard it behind Josie.
Felt it.
I felt it behind me as well.
Okay.
That seemed to resonate, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Could you please tell us your name, please? What was your rank? Where was home for you? Is anybody here from Texas?
Iowa.
Mississippi?
I think there was someone here from Iowa. That's what I shouted at.
Okay.
I don't know why I said that.
Okay.
It's funny because when you said Iowa, my Norman's giving me, now this is going to sound bizarre, Cambridge. So did whoever it was live at Cambridge and come here?
Or is there a Cambridge in
there
Iowa?
There probably is, because in that part of America, they have a lot of English names, don't they?
Yes, they do.
We'll have to check it.
Yeah.
We'll have to check it.
Does your family come here to see you? See where you served? Did you enjoy drinking in this bar? And dancing with the girls from Norfolk and Suffolk?
It's funny because I've got no...
Did you hear that bang?
I heard that.
It was a click, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. year are you here? Yeah. What year is this? 1940 what?
Come on, my lord, it's one off. Do we not have engineers yet? Can you say hello?
Is there anybody around us at this time? We mean you no harm. We just want to get to say hello. And for you to say hello, Black, would mean so much. It would mean so much. Not just to us, but to others that had family serve, that lost family in service. Just say hello.
Don't want me breaking anything.
Wow!
What?
I've got a mist.
Okay, never.
In here?
Wow, that's nice.
Oh. It's only over there. Where you were sitting.
Well,
here.
Here.
Just here,
yeah.
Behind
really?
You.
Really? Okay. Well, hi, whoever you are.
Yep.
Lovely of you to come and join us.
Would you like to come and sit with us and have a chat?
Oh, please do. It'd be lovely.
Don't be shy. Speak to us, because we'd love noise. To talk to you.
There's a noise over that side.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You get the noise the same
it.
Side all the time, don't we?
No, to me, it sounded further over, but it could be my imagination.
I think it's male. I'm not just saying that because I'm a cat, I do think it's male.
Yeah, because it could be female easily.
Quite strong.
It,
yeah.
Quite strong male. And yet nervous.
Do we have a ranking officer in here with us?
You came to our little island from your own country and you did what you did for us. I don't think there's many British people
that would
be proud to think that you were here.
We have a device on the table. I'm pointing to it now. If there's any way, just the slightest thing, noise, voice, anything at all that you can give us, we will be so, so grateful for. Because, you know, it's nice for us to be able to go home and let people know that you're there and that you're settled. And that you're happy. Because a lot of people, especially on the thing called Facebook these days, with the anniversaries of all the wars coming up, there's a lot of people out there that still got broken hearts and broken families. I think for us to be able to tell them that these guys are okay, and for them to hear it for themselves, would be phenomenal. So if you could just give us one word, I'd be quite happy.
May I ask you, are you standing quite close to the table? You are. Are you close to me? I thought you were. I can actually feel you. It's okay, I don't mind at all.
Wow. That's really lovely.
Morgan.
Morgan?
I've got the name Morgan.
Is your Christian name Morgan? Your first name?
Morgan.
Your family name?
Definitely got the name Morgan.
Yeah,
your family name?
Definitely got the name Morgan.
Your family name's Morgan. Well, it's really great that you come to say hello to us.
Yeah.
And you see, we're not bad folks.
No.
We don't mean you any harm at all.
I feel that
it's come back around the table.
Yeah.
I hope the camera's picking something up, because
yeah,
I feel like it's been
nice.
Around the table.
Yeah, that would be ever so
it's
nice.
Like he's corralling us in his own way, but.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's like
you're
corral.
I think he's passing around, just, you know.
Corrals. Yeah,
that's when...
You said Ohio earlier?
Oh, Iowa.
Iowa.
Are you from Iowa? Okay, I'm going to play some music for you. Here we go. You can tap the table if you like.
Colder than the other cold. Are you dancing with me?
I can't. You can touch the table, aren't you? Mind your eyes, girls. This was your band that was here.
Oh, I feel like someone's freezing me at the sides.
Yeah. I think it's just listening. How was that? Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy the music? Would you like any more? Hey, there's no need to be sad. It's okay.
I don't think it's sad. I think it's like memories. You know, like memories of his friends and colleagues
that.
And girls. Just the days, really, isn't it?
We have one more tune. Only one more tune with us. Would you like to hear it? You would, okay.
Anyway, we haven't come through melancholy.
No, we haven't.
We want to thank you for all you did. For you and your friends and your families. For helping when you could. Being brave. And giving us a chance for our lives.
Yeah.
And John and Jackie and myself would like to thank you. Because who knows where we'd be with that if you hadn't have done it. Do you hear the table then?
Yes.
Who knows where we'd have been without you?
Do you know, if it wasn't for your effort, every single person, the three of us might never have met. We might not have been here today.
Mm.
And we might not have been able to come here and say hi to you, to say thank you.
Exactly.
So a big thanks to everyone.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. And you just tell everyone else who's here with you tonight, because we know there's a lot more that we thank them as well.
Yeah, we do thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Hello guys, do you want to come in? This is the duty watch pilot's office, or it was, but now it's filled with all artifacts and things of the era, so John's just going to show you around. And come down here and look at these. Oh, it's so cold. Excuse my sniffing, I can't help it.
Oh, it's freezing. I'm sure there's a frost falling outside.
I just like putting these on, to be honest.
Yeah. These are very, very, very heavy. These are what the pilots wore.
And they're pure sheepskin, aren't they?
Yeah, keep them warm. Bless her little hearts. Gosh, that's warm. And then we've got these here. Will they come up nice and clear?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Well, you think how cold that was right up in the sky.
Mm.
You know, we think it's cold here. Look out when we travelled.
Yeah.
It was minus 50 when we go up high. So it's going to be a lot colder. Not that cold, but it's going to be very, very cold.
And I've got all these cases of displays here. We'll probably get the advantage because it's dark, but we don't know. But anyway, all the way through here.
I love this one here because it's got all the like bits of pottery, their mugs that people actually drank out of, and their little pots of whatever they used. It's just fascinating.
It is. So we just want, really, this is the group, so the group can see where we are tonight, really, isn't it?
Let's have a look at this then and see what we have.
So items in this cage were around, found around the tower and airfield.
Yeah.
So you're going back in time as far
the
as...
The old coke bottles.
Yeah.
Yeah, what is in China? What does it... Can you see what it says at the bottom of the mug?
1942.
Oh, that's Crescent China, which is an English make. 1944. Oh, something hotel. Grindley Hotelware Limited, 1944.
We all have the old towel and...
Yes.
Hotels.
What is that? Is that a regimental box at the bottom? That little round thing?
Yeah, it's American Eagle on it.
Oh.
The colours and history will be kind to me, for I intend to write it. So Winston Churchill. Naughty pictures.
Yeah, they like that. Those round things are what they mended the pots with. They had holes in them. They soldered it, didn't they?
This is a piece of flak that went into Edward Lewis's parachute.
Ooh. Which one?
It doesn't say. Just a piece of flak. It'd be this here.
Goodness me.
Yeah. Is this torch encompassing you in any way, Johnny?
It's okay, I'm trying to get through the glass as much as I can.
Okay. And also, you know who like this? Our American friends on Facebook as well, wouldn't I? Do you see that better without my torch on?
It's okay with the torch, really.
There you go, flying boot. There's all the signatures.
Oh, yeah. Are these bullets? I don't know what, but I just wanted to...
That must have been... I don't know what you call it, I'm going to be honest with you.
Combat use.
That would have been where all the...
Machine gun.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, where all the guns would have... The bullets would have gone in.
Oh, yeah, look, I can see the bullets there.
Yeah.
Because I've seen it on films where it goes all the way through, doesn't it, as it's going. That's a...
50 caliber was removed in 2004 from a crash site near Badwell Ash. The aircraft, called Stars and Stripes, belonged to the 385BG GT Ashfield. The barrel has undergone some renovation. There's your barrel.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing.
That's the gun site, that kind of thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now we've got these young men up here, these lovely handsome men.
So brave. So, so brave. Here we go. Once I've got the name on there. Staff Sergeant Patrick. Just to be in the presence of some of these is just mind-blowing, really.
This is a gun, look.
I know. Our group's going to love this. Pilot's Navigation Kit, Air Force, United States Army. There it all is. Hunting and survival knife. Oxygen masks. Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Right, let's have a look around the rest of the building, what we got here. They must have been so cold up there, you know.
Yeah.
We talk about here being freezing at the moment.
Yeah.
Just can't imagine it. And all the fear that goes with it.
I know.
Adrenaline must have played a huge part up there.
Oh, absolutely. Do you know what I actually love about the films, though? The camaraderie. I mean, it wasn't just the films.
No, but they had that camaraderie. And there's some medals in here.
First World War.
Is it?
Yeah. It's all from the First World War.
Royal Flying Corps.
There's Dinah Shaw. Bless her heart. She was one of Glenn Miller's favourite singers.
Yeah.
Yeah. She was over here when he was over here in the war.
Yeah, she came to this site.
Yeah.
Ladies in that picture.
I know. 1945 saw 94 continue their missions. Total missions 325. Wow. Look at the amount of bombs dropped.
Yeah.
Terrifying. May we here again be highly resolved that these dead shall not die in vain.
Wow.
Now I'm going to take you upstairs now.
The women, even in the war, were glamorous.
There she is.
Yes, yeah. They were.
Look at her cape.
Mrs. King, who in the past has donated a number of vintage radios from her late husband, those are now on display in the radio repair room. Mm. Now this, my lovely, is called a grey jacket. And the reason why I know that is because I've worn one. And out in the forces, yeah. That was our winter coat.
Wow.
The grey jacket is called. No, it's green.
I wonder why it was called a grey. Was it originally grey, I suppose?
I've no idea. I never asked them, Johnny.
Was it in the First World War they wore great coats?
Great coats, that's what they were called, yeah. Great coats.
With the little hat perched right on the top. What is that uniform? Signal? What is that? The middle
the
blue
collection one? Of air raid precaution items on display here are on loan to this museum by David and Patricia Wilding and consist of a warden's tin hat. There you go.
Yeah, oh, it's a warden.
A warden's civil defence tin hat, a gas mask and an anti-mustard film past tube and ARP greatcoat. And look at this lot. Look at this, guys. Actually worn by these men.
Now this one here I've seen on like on American war films,
yep.
This one.
And here they are wearing them. Ernest Wentworth, Mayon Bay, Nova Scotia. He had black hair and brown eyes. He was 6 foot, 1 inch tall, completed 1 year and 11 months, 2 days service for longevity pay, prior service none. Bless his heart.
And that's your typical A shape. Which virtually every airbase followed the same pattern. And those little globules that you can see is where there would have been an aircraft in every one of those. And considering we had B-26 and B-17s flying from here, that's a lot of air power. About pipe tobacco.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. I've got a photograph somewhere here of some of the pipe.
Where yeah, there's quite a few.
Really?
Always, yeah. I think it's
over
the other side.
There's some pipes here.
In one of the other rooms there is, I think.
Is there?
Yes, there
I can
is.
Smell it here. Right here. Quite strong. Just stand on this corner so you can pick it up. Got it?
jacket is his, right? It's from. That's rough tobacco, isn't it?
One more. It's got a kind of a chocolatey smell to it.
Yeah. Target Berlin, toast to those who fly. He's a toast to the host of those who fly, to the ones who will live and those who will die, to the ones who go down and to those who come back, to the ones who fly, the one who fight me's and sweat out the flak. A toast to the skipper, the man at the stick, he keeps head tucked in when the fighters are thick, to the kid in the stringer, the boys in the waist, the sin buddies go down to the death they have faced. Oh, to the radio man and the engineer, the dropper of demons, the bombardier, to the man who maps and plans a course, in whose hands trusted the mighty force. The ball, turret gunner, the co-pilot too, indispensable members of every crew, a toast in the end to the crew as a whole, a toast to the teamwork of every soul. Here's a toast to the hosts who fly, to those who will live and those who will die. Drink a toast and say a prayer for the next of kin. Your target today is the heart of Berlin. I wonder who wrote that.
No wonder. Wow. A-17.
Yeah.
Fantastic plane. We'd like to thank you all for letting us come here this evening. Thank you very much for letting us share your space. And if you've been kind enough to grant us your voice or given us some indication as to who you are, we'd like to thank you. Thank you so much.